Hey everyone, today I'm gonna show you something different. Usually I just show the elaborate environments that I create in detail, but today I wanted to talk to you about something else. I have been recently delving into photogrammetry and even using it for professional work. So today I just wanted to show you how I use photogrammetry in my workflow and show you a scene that I create using the objects that I scan. So without further ado, let's get into it. As usual, first I'll just start with putting a plane down and I'll make it pretty big, just about the size that I want my foreground environment to be. Just set up my camera and get a focal length of about 35. Then I'm gonna place down a plane. This is gonna be the road. The body below is going to be the water because I want to have some puddles. Now using the box tool in Blender, I just make this placeholder box. This is gonna be a house on the side. Usually I prefer to just do some block outs before I go into detailing into my scene, just get a decent composition. Then I'm gonna use the extra objects that come into Blender, and using that you can just create just a bunch of bricks laid on top of each other, brick wall, and you can customize a lot of these values. It's pretty handy. Then I just use this one click damage add-on that I use to just give it some tear and wear, and then I'm just gonna start placing it into my scene. After I'm happy with the way I place it, I just put down the basic human mannequin for scale, and now we get into the photogrammetry. This video is also sponsored by Curie Engine, and I'm gonna show you how I use Curie Engine's app on a daily almost nowadays for professional work to scan stuff. So I go outside, I know, and open the app and pick the object that I want as the focal point of our scene that we're gonna create today, and just start clicking pictures of it within the Curie Engine app. And I have the free version here, and you can click about 100 pictures of the object that you're taking pictures of. So I click about 20, which is the bare minimum limit, because I feel like even with just 20 images, Curie Engine does a very good job at recreating the object. Here you can choose the texture resolution and file format. I choose FBX, and you can click upload. After, it just takes a little bit to upload depending on your internet speed. And after the upload is done, it'll just take you back to the home screen where it'll show you that your scan is queued and it'll be processed. And the benefit of it is it just processes it on the cloud and then gives the final result to you that you can check out here on the phone itself. You don't need a high-end computer that does the processing for you. You can just do it from your phone itself, which is why I prefer using Curie Engine. It's just the flexibility. When I'm on the go, I can just scan stuff. Here, I bring the model back into Blender, as you can see. And now you can play around with the material as well. Like, you can use the basic albedo that you get and create some bump, create some roughness using the image itself. I like using the color ramp to play around with the values and the distance of the bump. It usually gives pretty nice results. You can even mix two different bumps. Also, Curie Engine has a website, so you can just sign in with the email account you have, and you can crop and edit the textures of the model that you have. Then you can also download it from here. You can just click here, download, and you just download the FBX. They also have a lot of great tutorials explaining all the functionalities Curie Engine app has. I love using it for photogrammetry, but it also offers a lot of other things if you're interested in, for example, Gaussian splats. I'll also show you some other things that I do with photo scans. These are also scanned using Curie, and you can also do some touch-up after you scan models from Curie and bring them into Blender. For example, here I scan these two, and now you can just go in Blender and just select some parts that you want to delete that you don't want, and you can just delete those. You can just create some basic cubes. You see, if you don't take enough pictures, and this was probably a mistake on my end where I didn't click enough pictures from different angles, you can just use booleans to cut those parts out. Like, cleanup is a pretty standard part of doing photo scans. Here I'm just using the sculpt tool, for example, because grass is notoriously hard to scan, so you have to, for example, use the sculpt brush to smoothen certain areas out. So just using these kind of techniques, you can also customize your assets a little more. You don't just have to use the exact photo scan that you got. You can modify it in different ways based on your need. And obviously I wouldn't just be recommending you guys something that I don't use or don't like or don't see any use in. I really recommend Curie Engine. I use it in my professional work on a daily. And thank you very much to Curie Engine for sponsoring the tutorial. So now, like, getting back into the scene, I import the Buddha statue that I scanned. I am going to create a base for it by just hand modeling it. I just take a cylinder and just extrude some bits out, shade it smooth, scale it up a little more. I also bring in this photo scan of a car from my library, but I am not 100% sure if this is from Sketchfab or I photo scan it myself. Now I start modeling out a little more onto the main building. I'm getting these roof parts from my previous video that I created where I showed you how to model this house. I also give them a little bit of a displacement. You can just go here and add some clouds and just give it a little bit of a strength, like 0.5. No, 0.5 is too high. 0.08 is good enough, maybe 0.1. Just gives it a little bit more displacement and realism. After that, I'm just gonna start creating a little bit more details, creating some pipes, creating some support beams onto the main building. I also use these metal bits on the side here, but like it's gonna be completely destroyed and unrecognizable. Here, just using basic cubes, I'm just creating stuff. Then I'm gonna do a little bit of booleans on the top to break it up. I'm just gonna create a cube, and then using that cube, I'm just gonna cut into it. Then I can just duplicate and mirror the same part. After modeling all these bits and pieces, we're gonna leave this building for now, but we're gonna come back to it to give it a lot more detailing and texture it. This is a building model that I got from Sketchfab. This video, I am trying to show how I do a lot of fast prototype work. For example, if I have to do a decent mock-up for some client or just prototyping stuff for myself, this is usually the process that I go through. I usually end up taking a lot of different things from Sketchfab and then using them as placeholders, like here I am doing, and using that, I create my final scene. But when I do more professional work where I have to hand model everything by myself, usually, for example, if you've seen my previous stuff, a lot of the main stuff I almost end up hand modeling myself. I am gonna try to post a longer tutorial of this on my Patreon or also on YouTube memberships. Now I'm gonna try to detail the main ground more. Here I'm just gonna put some edge loops and then subdivide it quite a bit so that I can use it to sculpt. And here, after subdividing, you can see I go into sculpt mode, and then I just start pushing certain parts down. And because we have a plane underneath, it's gonna show up, and that's just gonna act as puddles. I usually prefer this process when I'm prototyping. There's a lot of ways to do puddles in cycles. After that, for the main plane, I just mix these two different textures. I hand paint the image mask for them in the factor, and with a strength of 0.7, you can do it much better. Then, just using some image textures, I start modeling out this wall. But after I place it using an array modifier, I am not happy with the exact texture of it. The texture just seems too tileable and I'm not really feeling it. So I decided to swap it out for another texture. The benefit of using image textures is I literally just swap out the image and it just looks good. It works. This kind of workflow is just very fast and you can get decent results using it. Then use another image texture to texture the building. I use the same albedo for getting the roughness and the bump map from the image. I love color ramps. I'm sure I've repeated this like almost every video, but I just end up using them in almost every node tree I have like so many times. They're just so cool. Here I just create some booleans for the windows and the doors. And for the doors and the windows, I'm also gonna do the same exact process where I'm gonna bring in some image textures and just model them out based on the image. I add some edge loops, extrude certain bits. Doing this instead of just using the flat image just gives us better shadows and just depth that we require in 3D, so it looks good from a lot of different angles. Then I use a color ramp on a plane, plug that into the alpha to create some cloud shadows and just bring the clouds down quite a bit so that the foreground is in shadow, and I like how that looks. I use the same grass that I use in most of my scenes from Polyhaven. It's just very optimized and very good looking grass with a grass shader setup that looks good in almost every single environment. I would highly recommend you try their website out. It's also completely free. Then using GeoScatter, I just start scattering the grass. I also generally prefer to use an image mask when I scatter compared to vertex group because it's just more detailed. I also would heavily recommend you use multiple different particle systems, even for the same exact grass, one for lower scale and one for higher scale. It just gives it a little more fluffiness and more realistic scattering, where you can have a higher density low grass and then lower density taller grass in a higher scale. Then I start with the volume. As I already stated, I'm skipping through a lot of parts. I'll post a way longer tutorial about this same project on my Patreon and also on the YouTube memberships, so please wait for that. I think I'll upload the longer tutorial on the Patreon in a week, hopefully, maybe under that. Here I just do a little bit more detailing on the side building. I also added some extra lights, as you can see on the Buddha here, just to exaggerate the look. After I do a test render, I also like to do a little bit of compositing within Blender. I usually prefer to use the glare node set to high on fog glow to get a little bit of nice glow here. Then I sometimes use the hue correct node. Here you can just bump up the saturation value a little to get the blues a little more stronger in the scene. You can also adjust the white balance. Then for the final result, I take it into DaVinci to do a little bit more compositing. DaVinci has just become my like finalizing tool for even just still images. And after all of that, this is the final result. I really hope you enjoyed the tutorial. If you liked it, maybe consider subscribing and maybe check out my Patreon. Thank you.